Hi guys, this what you see is a microwave transformer. You can see that here it is written glass 230 volts 50 hertz. Okay, and what more you can see here is that there is no secondary winding and only this thick primary winding. And of course these are the two terminals with which 220 volt supply will be given to this. Now I used this transformer in a few of my previous videos, like making a high current power supply, a spot welding machine, etc. So here in this video I'm going to give you a few basics on this. Plus, I'm going to make a very powerful electromagnet with this microwave transformer. So guys, this is a 24 volts variable power supply DC voltage adapter. And at the back of it, you can see output DC 9 volts to 24 volts at 3 amperes. Input voltage 100 to 240, 50 to 60 hertz. So I'm going to use this power supply to show you one effect of this microwave transformer with a DC input source. Okay, so let's do that. So guys, these are the two terminals coming out from this power supply. Now when I will touch this, you will see that the voltage indicator here will go to zero because of the maximum voltage drop. Now you will also see the sparking, very little, almost zero spark. Yeah, very less. But you see this thick coil and this transformer is totally closed. The magnet circuit is completely closed. So I will connect one terminal over here, and when I will connect the other terminal like this, there will be no effect. But when I will release the terminal, there will be a huge spark because of the stored magnetic field in these copper wires. Now I will give you a closer view. Okay, so I have turned off the lights. Now guys, the spark was so high that the voltage was in thousands of volts and not just 9 volts that I fed through this power supply. Voltage from the output of the inductor is always very high, and that's why it easily fills the gap between the terminals even though the terminal gets disconnected. Now this was about the inductive effect. Now guys, at present the magnetic circuit is closed because of this bar. So if I will cut this bar with the help of an angle grinder and open it, it will become an E-shaped object like this and this, and it can be used as a very powerful electromagnet. So the first part is cutting the head off. Okay. So guys, as you already know that this was a microwave transformer, you can see that I have given a cut, a full cut on this side, and on this side you can see there is a full cut. So this what happens because of this cut is that when the cut is closed, then the magnetic circuit is also closed, and that type of setup is used in a transformer, a closed magnetic circuit for maximum magnetic induction in the other coil, secondary coil. But when we are making an electromagnet, then we need a half cut for a secondary metallic object to close the magnetic circuit, and that's how it is going to stick to the electromagnet. So guys, taking an example of this metal piece, now initially when this was closed, then this metal piece would not have stuck to the head of this transformer because the magnetic circuit was fully closed and no magnetic field was getting out of these poles. Okay, but when I'm going to place it like this, then the magnetic field is going to use the only path that is available for it to transfer the magnetic field, which is going to be this metal through this metal. Okay, so this pole, then this pole. So one pole, main pole, will be this, and the other pole will be these two, half on this and half on this, and this is how it becomes an E-shaped magnet. Not a powerful U-shaped, but an E-shaped magnet. These two together make one pole, and this single makes one large pole, north and south, or north and one south. Now guys, this is a power supply, 220 volts, up to 12 or 15 volts with a maximum current of up to 17 amperes. This is the voltage that is being displayed here, 14.5 at present. The link for this will be available in the description. I'm going to use this power supply to charge this electromagnet. So you can see I have used two thick copper wires because I need high current to flow through that supply. Connecting one terminal like this. Now when I will connect the other terminal, this coil will charge and this will become an electromagnet. Okay, it has charged. Now when I will remove this, you can see the spark, which is because of the inductance effect, which I already showed you a moment back. Now this is the metal piece that I was talking about before. Let's keep it like this, a little up on this transformer. You see? Now it is very difficult to pull it. I have to remove this to pull it up because the current flowing through this charges it to a very powerful electromagnet. Okay, so guys, let's remove this from this metal base. So guys, because half of the magnetic circuit is being completed because of this and this, so I will remove these so that the overall strength of the magnetic circuit gets on these three parts. Okay. So let's throw these away. Okay, so let's remove this part. So guys, as you can see, the coil is out of the transformer. Now what I will have to do is weld this part to this core on the sides. The coil is very nice. I can also use it to make a very powerful electric generator. Yeah, well, maybe in one of my future videos. Let's make what I'm going to make at present. So guys, as you can see that I've hammered the coil little upwards than it was before so that I can give a little weld on this spot. So guys, this, as you can see, is the final electromagnet. I have connected two wires for ease of connection, and this is the rod for holding it better. I have welded it to this transformer. Now this is the power supply, 14.5 volts. As you can see, this is what I'm going to use to power this up. So let's see if this power supply is strong enough to power this electromagnet and pull this weight. So guys, I think here you can see that it is showing 20 kgs. So let's try and pull this with this electromagnet. So guys, you can see that everything is set now. All I have to do is turn on the supply and the magnet should start. Yeah, the supply has been turned on. Let's stick it to this and see. Magnet is not formed yet. Some wiring problem, I guess. Yeah, there was sparking. I think it's working now. Yeah, it is working. Let's try and pick it up. Whoa! So guys, as you can see that it is easily pulling up this 20 kgs weight. Yeah, the magnet is very strong. It's not letting it go. Let's turn off the supply. And guys, now that I've turned off the supply, it should be easily removable. Yeah, you can see that now it is not sticking.